information about products on social media. But how much does it pay off for those big brands?
You mean like this fancy cup from CBS?
Now that's a good network. I'm going to watch those guys.
Lisa's with Ryan from Nerds on Call for more.
Just wait for it. Sales are going to spike for that.
Yes.
All because of you, Cody. All because
of
you.
I'm an influencer.
All right, so let's talk Insta marketing. It is a big thing.
It is a huge thing. So, hold on, let me go here. Okay, so with Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, 2.5 billion users are on these platforms. And one thing you got to keep in mind is that these people that are on here, a lot of times, if you've got a decent following, they may be selling something.
Okay.
And they may not always be totally upfront about it.
Okay.
So let me give you some examples here. Here's someone famous, right?
I've heard the name.
Yeah,
I recognize the name.
Is it Jen? Anyway, so she's, for example, here. She's slupping some tea here, right? She's like, hey, buy some freaking tea. She's a tea salesperson. That's who she is. That's why she's famous.
She wasn't even trying either. She's like,
I like the hair hold thing, you know, or the the butt shot.
Right.
Okay. All right, let me go back to this. All right. So that's called influencer marketing. And the interesting thing is you can be an influencer even if you have less than 1,000 followers.
Oh, interesting.
Did you know that?
No,
so,
I did not.
Well, let's talk about some of this cool stuff. So the reason why influencer marketing works is because most people don't see them as salespeople. They see them as friends or trusted advisors and things like that. And they post these pretty little pictures and you're like, oh, I want to look just like this person.
Yeah.
And so they buy the things that they're talking about.
Uh-huh.
Excuse me. So here's Kim and head-to-toe Fendi next to a trash can.
But it's a Louis Vuitton trash
can. Okay. Well, when she did this picture, there were 16% increase in searches for the Fendi brand.
Wow.
Now, this one, I don't remember her name. What's her name again?
That's the sister.
That's Kylie.
That's Kylie, right?
Kylie.
Okay, so she wore this. This is one of the many outfits she wore for her birthday.
Okay.
And after she wore this, 107% increase in searches for pink dresses.
Just for searches.
That's it. How crazy is that?
This is
a $10 billion industry, according to Forbes magazine. But here's the dark side. So there was brands that were actually paying for negative reviews of competitors. $85,000 to say bad things about an alternate makeup company.
Mm-hmm.
But you can make so much money
with
this kind of thing. 300 grand if you're on YouTube and you have over 7 million followers. Mm-hmm. But look, if you just have 100 to 500K, you can still make 1250 a year.
Yeah.
That's pretty great.
Yeah.
So to give you an example, $25,000 just for mentioning a product or a brand. If you do like a dedicated review, 50 to 60, 75 to 80 if you make a negative review of a competitor.
Oh, wow.
Pretty good deal.
Uh-huh.
So the FTC has certain rules. Like on CBS, for example, if we were schlepping a product, we have to say, hey, we got paid for this or whatever.
CBS.
So you have to do that on Instagram, too.
Yeah.
But they don't always do that. Mm-hmm. So here's Kim again, schlepping, I don't know what this is, some energy drink.
Yep.
But I don't see anything in here about it being an ad.
Mm-hmm.
But it is an ad.
Hashtags the name of, of the drink,
And so you can kind of see how that can be a little confusing.
Exactly.
You're like, well, she likes it, so she's popular. Maybe I'll try it out. So just keep in mind that there are bad things about this kind of stuff. And last thing is, if you're an influencer, you can be, if you have less than 1,000 followers, you're called a micro-influencer. And a lot of these companies will come to you and try to get you to sell their products. But here's the thing about micro-influencers. Not only are they cheap for brands to pick up, but they often will say things whatever the brand wants them to say. So unsubstantiated claims, things like that.
So you got to watch out for that.
So if you see somebody selling stuff or talking about a product, just be a little suspicious.
Okay.
It could be weird.
Interesting. It's a whole new ballgame, right?
Hmm.
Interesting. All right. Thanks for the insight, Ryan. Nerds on Call, always here to help on all things, really anything, as you just heard.
And look, the other thing, just real quick. So look, Hulisa's only got 8,100 followers, you guys. She needs to make a little cheddar. So come on, freaking A, just give her some more followers.
Eligible.
And look at poor Court over here.
Ineligible receiver.
8,182. And I won't even get started on, he's not really influential
Twitter.
At all.
He's a Twitter guy.
I'm a Twitter guy.
He's got a lot of followers on Twitter. All right. Oh, my goodness.
A whole new dress.
Right?
Thanks, you guys.
All right. Back.
I work for CBS, and I can't wait for another NCIS.
That's right.
Des Moines. All right, along with people, animals are also in big need in help